Hi everyone, Josh here at the Scott Arboretum of Swarthmore College. I am sitting in front of the Cunningham House here in the entrance garden. And today what we're gonna do is talk about two of the more popular early spring flowering bulbs. We're gonna look at tulips and we're gonna talk about daffodils. Two parts to this segment. We are gonna focus on how to care for those plants as they finish flowering. And we're also gonna begin to think about planning for next year's spring bulb display. Here in the Dean Bond Rose Garden, and right now the tulips are just beginning to finish. I think tulips are a really well-recognized and well-loved group of bulbs. They come in a huge range of colors, make great cut flowers, and really add the sort of stately elegance to the garden. And every year we add a few more tulips to the planting, knowing that some will not return. If you're looking for a tulip that is more apt to perennialize, to come back year after year, consider a species tulip or a Darwin hybrid tulip. Another thing that you can do to help your tulips have a greater likelihood of coming back is to remove the flowering structure after it's finished. Now, you don't want to remove the leaves, you just want to remove that flowering structure, and that'll divert the plant's interest, if you will, from making seeds into putting that energy into creating a bigger, more robust bulb, which will in turn give you a better flower. And what you're gonna do really is quite simple. You're gonna come, find your tulips. You can see here's one that's finished. And what you're gonna do, take your pruners and just really cut below. You're gonna leave the leaves, but you've removed the flowering structure. And that in turn will help you have a greater likelihood of having a display return the following season. Narcissus, also commonly known as daffodils, a hugely popular group of spring flowering bulbs. I think in part to two kind of key features. One is such a long bloom time. You can buy cultivars that begin flowering end of February, and like these, will last all the way through the end of April. The other reason I think they do so well in our gardens is that they're so tough. Pest-free, not a lot of critters bother them, deer and rabbit don't eat them, and really just perform year after year after year. And you can see we have a lot of daffodils here in the garden. With daffodils, I like to do a similar process as with the tulips and deadhead them if I have the time. Another trick as the foliage dies is to plant perennials in front to kind of hide that foliage. So here you can see I have a bunch of Monarda or bee balm in front of these. And every 5 or so years, I try to dig and divide my daffodils. And in essence, it's free plants. So here's a clump, and this clump, I have my spade here, and this clump started off as one single bulb. And over the course of many years, it's divided, it's made more and more bulbs, and it's ready now to be divided. So it's a process of, again, just getting your spade in the ground, and then with a hori-hori, you can begin to wiggle out each individual bulb. And then there you go. So plant that individually. You know, these are still in flower, so I would obviously wait until flowering is finished. But plant these out, and again, like I said, free plants, can't beat that. Even though we are still very much in the spring season, you are likely finding bulb catalogs arriving in your mailbox. You're likely getting emails advertising from different companies about their latest and greatest offerings. And yeah, it's a perfect time to be thinking about bulbs because, one, it lets you lock in particular varieties, maybe different bulbs that have limited quantities, so you're guaranteed that you will get that particular variety. And two, bulbs are very much on your mind right now. I'm really kind of paying attention to what the different bulbs in bloom are. And what I like to do is walk through the garden with my phone and take pictures of where I have different bulb plantings. So here above the rock wall, I have this little patch of grape hyacinths, which I really like. They've done really well there, and I want to add more. So by taking a picture of this general area and then printing it out and come October when I'm ready to plant, I have a good idea of that, hey, over here to the left is where I need to add those grape hyacinths. Okay, so go ahead, flip through those bulb catalogs, look online, and order next year's bulbs.